Hey babes, it's Kayla Kraft with the Mommy Millionaire Podcast. I'm a mom of three littles, ER nurse turned self-made millionaire, and lifestyle entrepreneur. I am bringing you inspiring stories, business and mindset tips to help you be shameless in pursuing your ambitions. Hey, Mommy Millionaires. Today, we're going to be talking all about how to increase your influence. If you want to be a better leader, you have to increase your influence. If you want to make more money, you have to increase your influence. Influence is everything. Everything rises and falls with your influence. So we're going to be talking about that today. But first, as always, I have got to remind you that Mommy Millionaire Live is coming up. I'm so excited because we have just gotten some more sponsors. These swag bags are going to be off the chain. And I was talking to Tiffany Carter, who is a master salesperson, money mindset coach, and she's teaching people how she sells a lot online using video. She's going to teach you her magic formula. But more than that, she's going to give you actual practical strategies that help you close more clients as well. So most of you guys that are coming are online marketers. It's really geared for online marketers. And it's teaching you, okay, you know, if you've had a $5,000 a month, I want you to leave knowing that November is going to be your first five-figure month. And if you've already done multiple five-figure months, let's make it a six-figure month, all by learning the strategies on how to scale your business that's already a proven model. It works. You've sold things before. Now, how do you grow it? We're going to be giving you all those strategies and working with you on your business for two intense days, October 24th through the 26th. The 24th is a VIP day where you're going to do a photo shoot with me and some amazing photographers. And then we have just a VIP party that is going to be amazing with so many little special surprises that I cannot wait for you guys to find out about. So head over to mommymillionaire.co and check it out and grab your ticket today. Honestly, if there is so many excuses, people are going on vacation. I'm like, listen, like, I plan my life around different events that I know I need to go to, and I will cancel a vacation in a heartbeat if I know it's going to give my family more freedom and me the tools that I need to actually grow my business. Okay? So ditch that list of excuses and head on over to the website because you deserve to have more freedom in your business. All right? So here's some quotes I love when it comes to influence. First one, you will never influence the world by being like it. It will be the people with the greatest love, not the most information, who will influence us the most. That was by Bob Goff. And Jim Rohn says, never mistake the power of influence. Okay? So here we are today, and the reason why I'm actually bringing this up is because I just got back from my company's convention, and you know, I just flew in just to do a team party for my team. You guys, I've been building a network marketing business for 8 years, and I mean, I've actively built it for 5 years. And the reason why I say actively is because then that's when I decided to pursue other things. And, you know, I've had some amazing, amazing leaders on my team that have really rose up and built their teams and just had massive, massive success. And one of my top leaders said, Kayla, I really want you to be at this event. Like, everybody needs to hear from you. And I was like, are you sure? I've been doing my own thing for a while now. And she was like, please just come. I said, okay, you know, I'm going to get it, rent out the largest suite at the Omni Nashville. P.S. The Omni Nashville failed me and I will never stay at that hotel again. So, you know, public service announcement, do not go to the Omni ever. If you're in downtown Nashville, go somewhere else. Okay. Thank you. The Thompson Hotel is very nice. I've stayed there before and that's where I would go again. So anyway, the power of a platform. Don't make me mad. Okay. So we rented out this beautiful suite and it had amazing views. And I said, yeah, you know, we'll just make it super low key. I'm gonna have some appetizers and everything. And I'm just gonna talk a little bit. And I really just want to pour belief into everybody because it's not about anything about pitching and da 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 da. You guys know it's all mindset, right? And so that was my goal for the night. Is I said, you know what? I'm just going to go and influence these people to believe them in themselves. And I opened up my door to the suite and I opened it up and literally the whole entire hall was full of people that I'd never met before that were all coming to see me. And these were all brand new people, just, you know, brand new to the company. And we couldn't fit everybody in the room. Basically, people had to take turns of coming in. I had people sitting on our bedroom suite and it was 1200 square feet. It was just crazy. I don't know why I'm giving you that much detail, but I'm trying to help you envision it. And people were hanging on my every word. And I don't take that type of responsibility lightly. And I take it very, very, very seriously because I realize the level of my influence, right? And so this got me thinking, I'm like, how did this girl, a 23-year-old girl who was an ER nurse, who tried out for many leadership positions, you know, growing up and never got picked, I would say I had very little influence growing up. How did I get myself to this position where I have people lined up and out the door wanting to talk to me? And so I was like, you know what? I'm going to figure out what the formula is. I studied myself on the airplane and said, what did I do? What did I do? Because when I first started network marketing, people thought I was a joke. I had very little influence. And then all of a sudden, year after year, my influence started to grow. And now I would say, you know, it's a pretty high influence I have over people. And again, like I said, I use that to inspire and empower people. And I do not take it lightly. And I am so freaking grateful every single day for it because I know God chose me for a reason. And it's a very, very, very special, special feeling to me. And so all of you guys need more influence, right? All of you guys do. You understand that the more attention you get, okay, the more impact you're going to make, the more attention you get, the more influence you have, the more money will just flow into your life. You become a money magnet. I'm wearing my money magnet sweatshirt right now. You can find over at mommymillionaire.co or if you come to the live event. And you know, I was like, okay, what is it? The number one thing, if you want to be an influential person, start today being consistent. Being consistent. When I was building my business, I used to do a 6 a.m. call. Okay. And I had just gone through John Maxwell's leadership program and I'd read so many of his books and I would just take a concept from the book and I would talk about it every morning at 6 a.m. And I did that. I committed to that for a whole entire year while I was in the real trenches of developing leaders within my company and in my organization. And you know what? Consistency. That was one of the hardest things I think I've ever done, to show up after I had just had my third baby and do that. Whew, that was hard to continue to show up. And I was consistent in everything I did. I had an event every Tuesday night, 7 p.m. at my house. You knew if you were on my team, we were going to be having an event on Tuesday night. You could just count on it for years, okay? So consistency. Every single time you saw me show up on social media, I was saying something positive. I was saying something that made people smile, made people think differently about their situation. Okay. From day one, I go back and I read my old posts. I'm like, oh, that was so cute what I said. You know, it's like a little watered down, like thought level leadership. And I'm like, that's just so cute. It's so cute. But it was inspiring back then. It was something different than what I would normally post. Okay. And it was very, very consistent. Every single day I was showing up on social media. And a lot of you guys will question, why don't I have influence over people? And I say, well, let's go look and see what your actions are telling the world, you know? Because if you have an audience of one, you got to be consistent for that audience of one. You know, now I have, I don't know, over 100,000 followers on Instagram, a large email list, whatever, you know, the list can go on and on. Okay. But I'm consistent for them. I have hundreds of thousands of people that listen into this podcast, and I love you guys so much for it. Thank you for sharing. That's how we've been able to grow. And here's the deal. I'm consistent. I'm consistent with showing up, even though I went through a little spout where I was like dry, but I still at least showed up once a week for you guys, right? And that's consistency, all right? That's how you start to build influence, because this leads me into my next point, okay? With consistency is that people know what they're going to get from you, okay? That's very, very, very important. But what it leads to is this. My next point is, if you want to be influential, you have to be trustworthy. And I look back on the first couple of years in my business, even though I had a little bit of success, I was making six figures. That was all from the hustle mentality. And because the way that my compensation plan worked, it was all teamwork. I got paid on every single person underneath me, even people I didn't bring in, right? And so it really worked in my benefit, because I wasn't a top sponsor. You know, I wasn't bringing in personal recruits in the beginning. And here's what I know. I think I wasn't as trustworthy in the beginning of my network marketing career because I was the ice queen. And I talked about this last night when I was in Nashville with my team. And I was very just like, I had so many walls built up around my heart and I wasn't letting anybody into them. It was like, do or die. I'm going to be successful. You're with me or you're not. Get on the train tracks or get off of them. You're in my way, right? And that was my mentality. And so I think people got that vibe from me that, gosh, she's not as perfect as she looks on the outside, but she comes off as just perfect and she doesn't show any weaknesses at all. You know, like I would be like, oh my gosh, I can't, I'm sell health and wellness supplements, so I can't post that I'm drinking coffee. Like I would only show the best parts of me, even though drinking coffee isn't bad. But back then, seriously, you could ask people that I enrolled. I was like, I would text them and be like, take that off your Instagram right now, or take that off your Facebook. You just said you drink coffee. We don't drink coffee. Like I was very like, anyway, whatever. It makes me want to roll my eyes, but I just love that version of Kayla because I didn't know what I was doing. But here's what I learned is I had to become trustworthy. I had to become the person that shows my whole entire team, hey, listen, I'm struggling at home right now. My husband doesn't support me. I had to get a babysitter because he won't even watch my kids for me to do this event right now. You know, or I'm doing this event with all my kids in the living room and him out with his friends because he doesn't support me. You know, and I just started saying that to people. I started to be honest with my team and say that I'm struggling here, but I'm not letting it stop me. I'm continuing to go forward. The moment I took the wall down and let people in to Kayla, the real Kayla, right? The good and the bad that comes along with being human. People started to trust me more. And now you guys know, if you're listening to my podcast, even just right now, you're knowing I share it all. I really do. There's very little. I mean, there's some things that you guys don't hear, obviously, but I try to be as real and share like things that are going on right now with you, because I want you to know I'm still in the trenches, still building my life, and know that you're never alone with that, right? And there's always going to be goods and bads in anybody's human experience. And so I want people to just know that their problems are not unique, right? And I think that makes me a very trustworthy person. That's why most people, they're like, what do you have that I can buy from you? Literally, people ask me that on the regular daily basis. What do you have that I can buy from you? So that just is a clue to me that I'm a trustworthy person. I know that too, because anything that I say I'm going to do, I do it to the best of my ability. And sometimes I fall short. Sometimes my best ability wasn't that great. But I know in my heart of hearts that I'm going to do whatever I can to make it right, right? So build up your trustworthiness. How do you do that? Number one way to do that is show the good and bad parts of you to your audience. And if you're a leader at all, show them that you struggle sometimes. You don't have to have this perfect persona, because people don't trust perfect, because we all know it is literally impossible to be perfect. Every single one of us has flaws. So, I mean, you don't have to like look like a hot mess, right? But you can show the intricate little parts of your flaws. I can't talk. Of your flaws. Third thing. This is how you build your influence. Let's talk about scarcity. Okay. I was thinking about this because when I was first building my network marketing team, and even now, I use scarcity a lot in building my audience. And I don't do it in a manipulative way. What I do it as is it actually is protecting my energy and it protects my time. And I'm huge on boundaries. But what I found is this is the scarcity tactic. You know, because I have such major boundaries, it makes people want me more, want the brand more, right? And it makes me actually more valuable. It makes my IP more valuable because you can't have access to it right now, right? So if you were to go to my website right now, you guys, there is literally nothing that you could buy right now from me except for a Mommy Millionaire Live ticket, which that still doesn't even happen until October, right? So you still have some time to wait to get access to me. And that's a scarcity thing. And all of you guys can be doing that. Most of us, we have this, you know, just open DM policy, open life policy. Anybody can pick my brain. Anybody can do this, right? And you have to train people to create the value around you, all right? And this is just human nature. We want what we cannot have. We know that, right? It's like, you know, I don't really like bananas, but if you tell me I'm allergic to bananas and I can no longer ever have another banana in my life right now, well, then all of a sudden I want a banana. It's crazy. It's just crazy. And all of you guys are laughing right now because it's true. We want what we can't have. And so how do you create that with your brand? You know, what can you implement? Well, it's, you got to put constraints on access to you. So, you know, is it going to be the fact that if people DM you and ask you a question, hey, you know, this is a great question. Will you post this in my Facebook group so everybody can learn? You know, that's the type of access you get. If you want me to ask a question, you got to ask it in the Facebook group because it helps build up the community in there and everybody can learn. So it's not just me basically giving you private coaching in my DMs, right? And so you, that's one thing that you could do right now today, train people. And then also think about what are the products that you just have ongoing all the time, especially if you're, you know, if you sell products on a regular basis, can people just buy them on any given day? Or do you go, hey, I'm only taking on 5 people to coach this month and my cart will be open for 24 hours. So you have 24 hours to start working with me. And, you know, maybe the first time you do it, one person signs up because you haven't trained them yet. But maybe the second time after all month long, you say, you know, I'm not enrolling again until I'm not selling these products again until this date. You know, put this on your calendar. I'll put you on my email list, you know, and we'll email you on this date. So just keep waiting for it. Keep waiting for it. And then send them teasers on the email list. Like it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. Then all of a sudden you open your cart for 24 hours and then you sell 10 instead of just 5, right? Because you created the scarcity around your offer. So put constraints on access to you. Is what I want to get across to you. Next way is this, to build influence. I was thinking about all these people in the room last night and before people were coming in, I was getting my head in the right state because like I said, the Omni in Nashville was a nightmare. And I thought, okay, Lord, are you punishing me right now? Because why is everything going wrong? And I was like, all right, I'm not going to let this type of energy affect what's going on. And I listened to Lizzo, Truth Hurts, because I freaking love that song. It makes me laugh. And then I said, what I want people to do is I don't necessarily want them to remember anything I said. I want them to remember how I made them feel. Because if they can capture that feeling of feeling special and they can bottle that up and go out into the world with feeling that way, then I know that's how they're going to be successful. Right? Because they can go Google tactics. They can go watch my coaching sessions online. They can do lots of stuff. But what they can't ever get again from me is the way that I made them feel the first time they met me. And what's the number one way to make somebody feel special right away? First time you meet them. Well, you compliment them, right? You make them feel special. And not just in the, I mean, maybe it is very superficial because you know, you're in a loud place and you can't really talk and you're like, oh my gosh, your braid is beautiful. Or, oh my gosh, that color pink looks amazing on you. And it's all genuine, right? But it's intentional, because what I know is when you compliment somebody, it instantly gives them they want to like you. They just want to like you, right? So now when somebody wants to like you, they put their wall down and they are open to your heart. So they're open to the love that you're radiating. Truly believe this. Okay. So how can you compliment more people on a regular basis? And I do this actively. When I was in the airport, when I was on the airplane, I'm complimenting people. You know, I got on the airplane this morning and the girl behind me had a crown on. And I was like, oh my gosh, like I never see anybody wear a crown. This crown is beautiful. And, you know, we started talking. I'm like, oh my gosh, like, you know, you're glowing wearing it. You look so happy. And we were just talking about it. And she just had this big smile on her face. Nobody else was talking to her at the airport. And, you know, I just in the constant practice of complimenting, because I want people to get that feeling. Well, what I know is that that's the way you influence people. And maybe she's listening in right now because I told her about the Mommy Millionaire podcast, right? So I influenced her to download the podcast and start listening. And because I believe we all are queens, baby. We're all queens. So another way you can influence people is similarities. So what type of similarities do you guys have, right? When you can build up that rapport, oh, I'm from Bakersfield, you're from Bakersfield. Oh my gosh, we have something in common. And now I'm a little more open to hearing what you're selling. I'm a little more open to hearing what you have to offer, right? Because you kind of get me, because you're similar to me. So another way to build influence is, especially on social media, you guys, so many of you guys want to grow your social media. And here's the deal. If you want likes and comments, if you want story views, guess what? Go and freaking give the likes and comments. Go and give the story views, right? It's the law of reciprocity, right? So when you do something for somebody else, it is human nature that you feel like you should do something for them. And this isn't always true. That's not the reason why you do it. But I'm saying this is how you build your influence, is just knowing that the law of reciprocity is at play when you take this type of action. It's coming back to you. Maybe it doesn't come back directly from that person, but it comes back in some way, shape, or form, right? And so believing that, knowing my influence is growing because I'm giving. And going forward like that. So I want you guys to think, how can you implement this in your daily life? You know, again, with trustworthiness, it's okay, show the good and bad. With scarcity, create limited access to you and compliment more people. Be very intentional about your comments, you know? And then the last thing I want to talk about is social proof. You guys see I do this a ton. And you train people to talk about you, right? So you guys know, like, I try to repost all of you guys. Sometimes it's like, it's too much. I'm like, I can't post all of these because I'm going to get like, people don't need to see this much social proof, but I want you guys to know I'm so forever grateful. And I try to pick people that I have never reposted before too. Just so you guys can all get a chance to be reposted by my account. I'm very intentional with that. And anyways, long story short, I'm sharing this because it's, again, human nature for us to want, believe, do, or feel the way that other humans are feeling, especially other humans that are comparable to us, right? So if we see other life coaches doing a program, listening to a podcast. If they're listening to it, oh, okay, I'm a life coach. I need to listen to it too, apparently. Like, that's the social pressure, right? Because you feel like if they're doing it, I need to do it. It's literally human nature. So the more social proof that you can share, the more influence you're going to have. I'm constantly sharing testimonials. I reward everybody that works with me for giving me a testimonial. You know, I will repost people. Anybody that shouts me out, I take screenshots of it and I use it later in promo material. We talk about it and I'll say it out loud in videos to make on IGTVs and shout out people's names. And, you know, we do it just alone to build this podcast. We tell people in ads, this is what people are saying in the reviews of this podcast. And I just realized that we haven't done a review of the week. And so we'll end with that and tell you guys what that is. But how do you get that to happen? Basically, what you do is you start asking people to do it. Hey, if I've helped you in any way, shape, or form, would you shout me out on social media and just tag me so I can repost? Because I'm looking to have major impact in this world. And if you could say it in your words, how I've helped you, I can actually help more people. And it would mean everything to me if you could do that. Or you ask people, hey, like, before, you know, when you bought my program, where were you at in your life? Like, what was your current state? Let's say you were selling a money mindset course. What was your current financial state? How were you feeling about money? What was your financial situation? And guide them on how to answer this question. You know, find out how bad was it? How bad was it? And get in their words, you know, how did you help them? How did you transform? And then share that stuff all over the place because people believe other people that are talking about you, right? That's why bad reviews put people out of business if you got a lot of them. But good reviews go a long way. All right, so let's give a shout out to Alexis 2014 exclamation mark. She gave us a 5-star review and she said, I'm seriously obsessed with this show. The first show I started listening to and practically the only one now. I feel my life has changed because my mindset has completely changed. It also has influenced me to start my own network marketing business. Thank you, Kayla, for steering me into the right path for me. Aw, I love that. That makes me so happy. Yay, Alexis. How cool. You'll have to write me and tell me what network marketing business you started. Cool, cool, cool. So you guys, those are some things. I mean, I could literally go on and on about influence. It'll be a part of my new book that's coming out in 2020. I'm so excited. It's going to be all about everything. Everything that I think is going to impact your life. No, really, it's going to be about sales and influence. But just to give a shout out, the other day on my social media, I asked people, I said, hey, you know, I'm meeting with a big publisher and I'll announce soon once everything's signed. And I'm looking to get a very big book deal. But the one thing that was missing from my proposal is they wanted to know, like, what makes you so special, Kayla? Like, why do people listen to what you have to say? And I just went to you guys and I said, hey, help me out. And I used the little questions thing on feature on Instagram and hundreds of you guys wrote in, which really meant the world to me because sometimes I'll do stuff and like, it's like 3 people ask a question and I'm like, really? Can people not like respond to this? But I think it was because the way I went about it, I really said, I need your help. I can't do this without you. Like the reason why I want to write a book is to impact more lives, honestly. And that's like, I know the stuff that I'm putting in this book is going to help so many people become more financially abundant. Like it is literally freaking gold that's going to be in there. And so you guys helped me out. And something that Nicole Dawn said, she said, after listening to you, I can have whatever I put my mind to. I love hearing your term, brainwashing ourselves into believing into ourselves. Somebody said, I have learned to give more and the giving is receiving. I also feel empowered to do it. Ati says, Kayla is real, brings out the feelings, holding you back to the surface and genuinely calls you out. Sarah Wall Street said, realest woman in the game. And I screenshotted everything and sent it over to the publisher. And it helped me tremendously. And I seriously am so, so thankful for this tribe of mommy millionaires and the daddy millionaires out there that listen in too, because I know that we can't do this alone, right? And all of us influence in our own way. Maybe you feel like you have very little influence right now. Well, if you're a mom, you influence your kids every single day. If you're a wife, you influence your husband every single day. So how can you use these tactics that we just taught to influence more, you know? How do you do that? And I can't give you all the answers, right? But what I can say is instead of going, getting frustrated, ask yourself better questions and journal and go, how do I become more trustworthy? How do I create more social proof? You know, what is it that people really learn from me? You know, how do I create scarcity in the business? And use your imagination to answer those questions. You guys become a problem solver to increase your influence, right? And just a reminder, if you loved this episode, right? I know you did because you got massive amounts of value from it. These are practical tips you could put into play right now. Screenshot it. And tag me on Instagram. Tell me what you learned. And I want to challenge all of you guys. Okay. This is a huge challenge. If you feel like your influence is down in the dumps, here's what I want you to do. I want you to rate your influence over yourself on a level of 1 to 10 and say, hey, you know, at the end of the day, am I 100% influencing myself to do all the things I've ever dreamed of doing? And honestly, a lot of you probably look at that and go, I'm probably a 5, right? Because a lot of you haven't captured the power of your mind. And if you need help with capturing that, right? Really learning how to influence yourself. When you influence yourself, that's when you can then influence the many. In a couple of weeks, we'll be opening up the Millionaire Society, which is a mindset membership program. I go live a couple times a week, working with you on your mindset. I will coach people live, and it's all about transforming those thoughts, those limiting beliefs, those things that are holding you back. You know, the reasons why you self-sabotage and you procrastinate and you have this perfectionism issue. Like, we will tackle all of that together in this membership program. So if you're not on my email list, head over to mommymillionaire.co. Make sure you're a part of it. So that way you'll be notified when the society opens up again. Because again, there's that scarcity tactic at play, right? It'll only be open for a couple of days and then it goes away until 2020. So really great opportunity for you guys. There's two ways that you guys can get coaching by me right now, right? You come into the Millionaire Society group, or you can come to Mommy Millionaire Live. And from the Mommy Millionaire Live stage, we will launch the 2020 mastermind that you can be a part of. So there's so many ways that you guys could be investing in yourself. If you hang out with more influential people, all of a sudden you become more influential because you start to raise your thermostat of influence, because you start to think like an influential person. You start to talk like an influential person. And that comes with hanging out with other influential people, listening into this podcast, gathering my belief, using these tactics that I've used for years to impact thousands and thousands of people for the better. And I love you guys so, so much. I hope to see you at Mommy Millionaire Live. And go out there. And instead of focusing on the things you want, I want you to focus on the things that you desire. And I want you to focus on building more and more passion around the life that you're creating. Love you guys.
Thank you for listening to the Mommy Millionaire Podcast. For free resources and materials, head over to mommymillionaire.co. Make sure to follow Mommy Millionaire on Spotify and subscribe on iTunes. And it would mean the world to me if you left a 5-star review of the show. And as always, ladies, go out there and get what you want.